In this Adobe Firefly tutorial, we'll be diving deep into Generative Fill and its techniques. So without wasting any time, let's get started. Hey everyone, and welcome back to my YouTube channel. If you are new here, then please subscribe to my channel, which will keep me motivated in creating more helpful videos for you. You can also support me on Patreon if you want. I'll put the links in the description. Alright, let's open the Firefly website and navigate to the Generative Fill. Now you can upload your own image or choose one of the examples from here. I'm gonna upload my own image. You can see some tools on the left side and some at the bottom. You can zoom into the photo by pressing and holding the control key, then scroll your mouse wheel back and forth to zoom in and out. You can select this pan tool and move the image around. There's also a shortcut for this. If you have selected any other tool, then press and hold the space key. When you see this hand icon, then you can click and move around. If I click on this background button, it's gonna remove the background. And it has done quite a good job there. I'm gonna type some prompt text here. Let's try a park with the river. And there we go. It's giving me three options to choose from. And I can generate more options. The good thing about this is that it's gonna keep all the generated versions, so I can go back to the very first, compare them with each other, and then choose the best one. I'll proceed with this one. Next, I'll draw some area somewhere around here. And it'll ask me to type something here. Let's try adding some ducks. This one looks good, but let's try another version. This one is also good. I'll keep this one. Alright, let's proceed further. From here you can change the brush settings. If you have used Photoshop before, then you are already familiar with these. You can change the brush size and increase or decrease as per your need. Then you have the brush hardness. If the brush hardness is low and I draw some area here, you can see the blurry edges which are blending in with the image. If I increase the brush hardness and draw something, you'll see some sharp edges around your selection. If I click on this clear button, it'll clear my selected area. And you can adjust these according to your needs. Next, you have the brush opacity, which is very helpful. To explain that, I'm gonna change the opacity to 60%. I'll zoom into the face and draw some area here for the beard. Now when you draw with low opacity, then it'll preserve some of the pixels in your selected area. I'll type beard and hit generate. As you can see, the beard is not very thick in these images, because it's preserving some pixels of the original image. I'll clear this. Now I'll change the opacity to 100% and make the same selection. When making a selection, if you draw some area by mistake that you didn't want it to draw, then select the subtract tool and you can deselect the area which you don't need. Alright, hit generate. As you can see, now we are getting very thick beard. Alright, let's clear it. Next, I'm gonna draw some area here. And let's try adding a board. I'm gonna generate more versions. This one looks good, so I'm gonna keep it. Now there are some additional prompt settings. to explain that, let me draw some area here. This is going to be a nice little bay. Now if I click on this icon right here, it's gonna show me some extra settings. First you have the match shape, and by default it's set to freeform. I'm gonna change it to conform, and now it'll try its best to utilize this whole space for the new image generation. Let's try it out. As you can see, it's trying its best to fill in content in all of our selected area. Let's change it back to freeform and hit generate. Now in these images, Firefly is trying its best to generate content that looks good with the surroundings, and it will ignore the extra drawn areas if necessary. Let's keep this one. If I click on the background button, it's gonna remove it. And sometimes it keeps the other generated subjects and sometimes it doesn't. Now what if I want to keep the background and remove this person instead? If I click on this invert button, then it's gonna invert your selected area. Now I don't want to change the face, so to exclude something from your selection, you can select the subtract tool and exclude that from the selection. I'll adjust this a little bit. I'll also deselect these from here. In the prompt settings, next you have the preserve content. If it's set to new, then the original content of your image will not be followed in the image generation process. Let's see what we get. And it's giving me some colorful t-shirts. Now if I go back and keep it closer to the original content, hit generate. In original image, the person is wearing a white t-shirt, so it's following that in the image generation process and giving me some nice white t-shirts. So it all depends on what you want to generate. You can also use this feature to create variations. For example, if you want to see some variations of your background, I'm gonna select the background. And let me deselect the other subjects, cause this is just for the demonstration. In the preserve content, I'll keep it closer to the original image this time. Hit generate. And it's giving me variations of the previous background to choose from. Now if you want to remove something from your image, there are two ways to do that. I'll select the remove tool. Let's try removing this beer from here. Click on remove. And again, it's giving me three options to choose from. The second method is that you can select the insert tool and draw over your required area. Now to remove this, I'm not going to type anything in the prompt box and hit generate. It's gonna take inspiration from the surroundings and fill in that area. All these look good, I'll choose this one. You can also use this technique to fix something that don't fit in your image. It's kind of a healing technique. For example, let's try removing this weird looking spot from here. Not sure what exactly that is, so let's move that. Simply hit generate without typing anything. None of these would work. Let's see another version. I'll keep this one and let's do it one more time. And I'm gonna go with this one. Finally, I want to change the dress of this person. I'll draw some area here. I'll draw a little bit more around the neck. And that will work. Let's try creating a business suit. There's one last thing, that is guidance strength. If it's set towards the original image, then Firefly will also take inspiration from the surroundings. It can be color combination, some elements or pixels from the image or so. But if we set more towards the prompt, then the generated content will be guided more by the user's prompt. This means that Firefly will generate content based on the user's specific instructions or prompts. First, I'm gonna keep it towards the original and hit generate. I like this one. I'll download this one so we can compare it with the other. Let's see another version. This one also looks good. But this one is fitting very well with the overall image. Alright, now I'll move the guide and strength more towards the prompt. Hit generate. This is also giving some good results. This one is very good. Let's see another version. I'll download this one. Alright, let's see the comparison. This is the first image, in which the suit was generated with guidance strength set more towards the original. And in my experience, these results were blending better with the overall image. This is the second image, in which the suit was generated with guidance strength set more towards the prompt. It also gave good results, but if I dive into detail, then this suit is not fitting well with the overall image. It feels kind of a bit more elevated compared to the overall image. So which one of the settings you should choose totally depends on your needs and what you want. I'd recommend you to experiment with all the settings and see what gives you better results. So that's the end of this video. In the next part, we'll talk about creating text effects. Make sure to check the next parts of this Firefly course. You can find all the links in the description. If you enjoyed this video, then please like and subscribe to my channel so I can keep on making more videos for you and provide you more solutions. If you have any questions or feedback for me, let me know in the comment section. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Have a great day.